So this is the part two as to how to draw a beautiful floor plan. And in this video, I will be going over the details of a floor plan that really elevate your floor plan and drawing quality. So in the past video, part one to the series, if you want to check it out, click up here. I went over the drawing basics, how much I offset my walls, what the basic definition of a floor plan is. But today I really want to go over the importance of Entourage, exporting your thing, hatches, all these minor little details that really elevate your floor plan. Your girl Nat here, and if you are new to the channel, my name's Natalie. I am the creator behind Unraveling Architecture. I'm so down for helping out other architecture students, so please be sure to like and subscribe to the channel if you are new. It really helps me out. Also, leave me a comment down below with any questions or concerns you have about drawing a floor plan. I'll just jump right into it. Once again, if you did not see that video, this is just a part two to this series, so you might be a little confused as to what I'm talking about if you did not see the first video. But Entourage, I want to say briefly, like I touched in the last video, Entourage is important because it kind of shows the circulation quality of your building proposal. So it's great. I get all of my Entourage from Dimensions, and I also actually hand trace a lot of my Entourage just using basic Entourage stock photos off of Google. I only recommend really using line work. You don't want to take away too much focus and attention from your floor plan just to the Entourage. So still, Entourage is really important. Just keep it simple. The second thing I want to talk about is hatches. Now hatches, you could either add them in Rhino or in Adobe Illustrator. Now for sure, you know, there's pros and cons to both. So let's talk about adding hatches in Rhino 6. So Rhino 6 is great. You can actually plug in a lot of pattern files to your Rhino program, giving you access to a more variety of hatch work. Basically, you just type in the work command hatch in the command bar, a pop-up window will come up, and you have a bunch of options for a lot of hatches to add to a closed boundary in your Rhino file. And downside to hatches is that if you have a doubly curved surface, you will not be able to add a hatch to that. So you will kind of have to hand draw hatches if you have a curved surface. I encountered this problem a lot with my Penn Museum expansion proposal titled Flow, and you can see more of the work that went into Flow in my 24-hour render transformation challenge. The one important thing that you should know if you do hatches in Rhino is that you are going to have to explode your hatches into thousands and thousands of line work and immediately group it. Group it, and then that will be the best way to export your hatch work into Illustrator. Now, I personally use a lot of my hatches from Illustrator. I don't recommend using the wildly colorful ones. Like I mentioned in the first video, you really want to make sure that your floor plan is black and white. I would not dissuade you, but I really would not recommend adding colored hatches and stuff like that, just because hatches are kind of an additional detail that you can add just to kind of elevate your drawings a little bit. They aren't necessarily needed, but if you have hardwood floors and you want to add a hatch showing that this is in fact a wooden floor, that's great, go do it. But you don't want to oversaturate the colors in your Rhino file. That's it. I'm getting off the soapbox now, but just so you guys are aware. Poche wise, you could also do white, gray, or black fill. I've personally been really fond of the white filled poche. I think it is very beautiful, it's very clean, and it's also lighter than just the heavy black poche fill. But once again, completely up to you. And a good command to know is the paint bucket tool in Illustrator. So if you are debating on poche and other fills, what I do is I will select everything in Adobe Illustrator. I will copy and paste in place on a new layer and paint bucket it. The command I think is K. And you just paint bucket it, select and fill whatever you want fill. And this is a great tool because you can actually hide some of your mistakes and boo-boos with a white Poche Fill. Now, also another good detail to add to your drawings is actually a scale at the bottom left corner of your work. I touched on this in the first video too, but just add a brief little scale. You can color it however you want. I've seen people draw this scale figure with just a line, or you could do black boxes. Sometimes I do both. It depends on my mood, I guess. Completely up to you, but just good to kind of orient yourself with it. Another thing you can also do is add a render with a lot of shadows underneath it using a plugin for Rhino called V-Ray. But if you do decide to do this, I recommend only doing a black and white render and just trying to show the shadow quality of the walls and whatnot. This is really successful either way. Site context, you should also consider adding site context. If you want to add some topo lines or some fake topo lines, totally fine. We've all done it. I recommend using the command tween curves. It's great. It kind of just takes two curves and creates this line work in between these two curves that you select the parent curves and gives the illusion of topo lines. They don't have to be perfect, and in the end, these are just theoretical projects that you are producing as a student. So don't stress yourself out about topo lines, but it is a nice detail to add. Another great site detail to add would be trees, cars. You could add the little dashes in the road, all that cool fun stuff. I typically do a heavier grass hatch. It makes the drawing more legible and gives a bigger differentiation between inside and outside. Now, let's say you are taking your drawing from Rhino into Illustrator. When you export selected or export with origin selected, a pop-up window will come up and you have the option to scale your drawing. And this is just how I scale it. I typically do 1 foot, and let's say for this instance we're doing a quarter inch scale, so you would put 0.25 inches. Basically, you just write the actual numerical value of a fraction of whatever you're doing. So if you're doing 1/8, then you would do 1/8 and find that that's 0.125, and you would put 0.125 in that little window. And that's how you perfectly scale any drawing. That's why it's so important that you actually draw your floor plan to scale in Rhino and go from there. Before you know it, you have a really good drawing. Architecture definitely is in the details, and I hope that this video helped you guys out with some tips and tricks that I personally implement in all of my floor plans. I hope that these time lapses were helpful for you guys, and if they were, please be sure to give me a like and subscribe if you are interested. Like I mentioned, Discord, Patreon, all that good stuff, so please do whatever you are comfortable with doing, and I really hope to see you guys in the next video. Until next time, love you guys.